Hi everyone, Sivan Tenna back, and there have been a little while since last review, and there is a reason for that. I have been ill since 25th of December, which means that I lost my voice, I lost a little bit of my hearings, which means that the air switches, working, not working, and so on, and my nose was completely blocked. So I have used a lot of nose spray, cough medicine, and all of that, to get well again. So if you hear me do this, it's because I need to clean my voice, okay? So bear over with me for that, because my voice might try to shut down when I speak to you now, because I just barely recovered and I feel comfortable enough to make a review, okay? And I'm gonna show you some magazines today, very nice magazines actually, that dates all the way back to 1973. And that is a magazine called Disneyland, and this is magazines for children. And today it is for adults, that's for sure, because some of the characters back in the day is no longer around in the Disney franchise. But that's because of different reasons. And I'm going to explain later on down the road as I show you the magazines, because I have a couple of those magazines here. I managed to get them in a second-hand store. And despite that the first magazine I'm going to show you says free sample at the front, this cost a lot of money. And it has its tear and wear since it is just a regular paperback magazine. So you will see some marks here and there and a little bit of, what can I say, curly at the edges and all of that. That's nothing to do about it. I'm gonna do my best to show you what I'm gonna show you today. So I hope it's okay for you that I wait with the game review to next time so I get more well in my voice, okay? But anyway, we're gonna start with the first issue that it says it's free at the front. And I'm just gonna do this. 1973, everyone. It says 30 of January, number 1, 1973, week 5, I think. Is it that? I can't see. Let's see. I think it says week 5. That's, is that, yeah. Of course, it might be week 5 because you're about to go over to February. Okay. Anyway, first issue it says, and as it states here, it says Child Magazine. Oops. I have to hold it a little bit. It's a very big magazine with an A4. This is, as it says here, it says extra. A funny Disney Uro to hang on your child wall or hang up on the roof in a string. And Uro means that it can move. Yeah. It's a movable something that you hang up on the roof and when the wind catches it, it makes it move. Something like that. Tinkerbell is at the top here, you can see that. If I twist it like that, you can see it better. Yes, and here are some characters from, is it Jungle Book? Is that a younger Bagheera I see right there? I don't know, and that's a monkey I can't remember the name of. Free test samples. This character here is no longer around, so is it for this character, the crow down here with a cigar in his mouth. When did you see somebody with smoke in the mouth in a Disney magazine? You can see if I do this, and I have to do this so you can see the other side as well. You can see Mickey Mouse. You can see, I can start here first. Mickey Mouse, Peter Pan, Dumbo. You can see Mickey. There, Pinocchio. I think I mentioned that already. Some Dalmatians. I don't know if it is from 101 Dalmatian. I don't know if they were around at that time or if it is other characters. I don't know. It's not, I cannot fit the hole into the camera or the front page, okay? So I have to slide this, okay? So this is the first Disneyland magazine from 1973. And at the back it says something about the magazine. I'm gonna angle that to the camera first. Let's see, I have to twist it a little bit. Can you see this? I have to slide it and I'm bumping into the box the tripod stands on, okay? If I do this first, you can see Mickey Mouse. You can see hello girls and boys, it says. I have to do like that. If I do this, can you see that? Yes, I think you can. Pause and read for yourself, okay? And here is some elephant and other characters from the Jungle Book. And you can see also the dwarfs from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs is my guess. And this, I can't remember all of the characters, okay? And this is the one that owns Pinocchio. Goes with a flag there. And you can see Pluto here. And some of the cats from Astro Cats or whatever it calls. I can't remember, okay? And you can see that the characters has different drawings from another period of time. That's the way it is. Let's see if I can find some cool pictures inside this before I go to the next magazine here. Let's see. Just to show you. Dumbo the Flying Elephant. Yeah, there is a story about Dumbo. Let's see if I can pick out some pictures for you there. That's the... Let's see. I have to do this. Yes. So, and that's the circus director. Yeah, in the circus. So that's Dumbo for you guys. And you can see Flying Dumbo there is collecting hats that has flown in the water. So this is very neat. I gotta say that. I like this. You can see also it has some punch holes down here. And that's not done by me. That's done by the previous owner. So maybe I should put this in something to store it in. And you also got Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Yeah, some nice picture there. Where they are all together in the snow. Yes. And it also has some commercial for Disneyland here. Let's see if I can hold it so you can see this. It's not easy. Welcome to Disneyland. Yes. So I'm just gonna slide and show you some pictures, okay? And there are some pictures of some animals at the side here as well. So I think this is a neat... This is an old magazine, I gotta say that. And I think it's pretty awesome to have. It has been very yellowed and all of that, but... Don't forget, it is all the way from 1973. Lady and the Tramp. And with a dog called Fant. Yes, that dog is no longer around in the Disney franchise. And you can see them there. So Fant is there. Is it the son? I don't know. I can't remember, everyone. That's Fant for you. And that's the one that wants to catch the tramp. As it's called here, and catch the dog and get it into the kennel. Yes, so that's the way it is. So this brings back a lot of memories to me how the Disney characters should be, and I think it's sad that they doesn't these characters not no longer in use. And here is Jungle Book. An angry elephant. It says the Jungle Book at the top here, in Norwegian, of course. And you can see that it's a little bit hard to show you pictures here, because it is a little bit washed out, the colors as well. But what do you expect? It's very old, okay? Pretty awesome to see this. So I want to share this with you guys. And here you can see you got some puzzles you can do and all of that. And here is... the Mickey and his apple party, okay? It says so here in Norwegian. So read for yourself, okay? I'm just gonna slide. So you just pause for yourself to read the story. It's that simple. I'm gonna do it like that because it's much easier. So you get yourself a story. So just pause the camera. And here there are some drawings. Probably some deers there. And you can see Tussie from Winnie and the Pooh. Yeah. Trying to eat a carrot of some kind. And Cinderella's Goodnight History, okay? Yeah. It says so at the top here, if I can get it into the camera here. Sorry for the light angle, I have no choice for that. So yeah, it's a good night story of some kind. And you can see the wolf is in and wants to steal some cookies and... all of that, and he runs away angry. So yeah, it's cool, this here. And yeah, I'm gonna show you a little bit more. And here is more of the Jungle Book. Yeah, here is Shere Khan looking at the boy, and he wants a meal. He wants the boy to eat, but he's getting chased away by the other animals. very quickly. And you can see she sleeps there, and Shere Khan has to walk away. And he tries to find up a plan and all of that, to hide in the tree log and all of that. And then the elephant steps on him, and he gets revealed that he's trying to hide in the log. That's how it is. Yes. So there you have that. If I mix he or she, that's just me. That rhymes, actually. Alice in Wonderland. It also gives a story about that. Yeah, looks like that. So it's an all-time classic, actually. So I think this is actually very cool. So let's see if I can get some more picture here. Do my best here. And there is some more drawings you can do. Yes, Lady and the Tramp again with Fant. Different story this time. I'm just going to show you some pictures and move on. You can see it's an old magazine, by the way. So there you have that. Yeah, I think this is a very cool. One more page before we go to the next magazine. Yes, Pinocchio and his friends, of course. Yes, there we have Pinocchio. And Pinocchio is probably going to take a dog for a walk for an old lady. Yeah. And that's the way it is. Yes, I think this magazine series is very cool. And here he tries to drag the dog. And Timmy is at the back to push. Okay, that's how it is. And the backside I showed you before. So I'm going to put the magazine down here. And find the next magazine of Disneyland. Okay. This is number 4. I'm not putting this in order, okay? I just got a couple of these magazines and I have to show you what I got, okay? And here Mickey is driving a train. You can see Huey, Louie and Dewey in the wagon, and Donald is there. It's a little bit weird off, so you can't see the whole face of Donald here, okay? Tinkerbell is at the top, where the Disneyland logo is. If I do this, you can see this. It's not easy to hold this, because this is so big. But I'm gonna do my best. This is the back of it. And here comes the cross again. I can't remember where this is from anymore. But that's the way it is. Here it says, hello boys and girls again. You have seen the text before. I'm just gonna show you Mickey and move on. You can see the cross here again. And you see the train here. This is the back side. Probably, if I do this, I don't think I can fit it into the camera, but if I do it like this, you can see the whole entire page like that. Yes, it's too big for the camera, that's for sure. I'm gonna show you a little bit inside here as well. Let's see. So, I think that this is cool. Dumbo, the flying elephant again. Yes. So, yeah. I'm gonna do this just to show you this and yeah, do my best. Here they are at the circus and you can see them flying there, collecting balloons and all of that. And a clown is sitting on his back, on Dumbo's back. Alright, let's move on. Alice in Wonderland, yeah, there he talks to a mouse and so on. And yeah. I can't remember all of these old stories anymore. It's so long since I read this. But this brings back a lot of memory, I can tell you that. And here you can draw a clock. Somebody already did that. Yeah. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Okay. I'm just gonna slide like that so you can see this, okay? And this is history, actually. Because a lot of the characters in this one you can't get anymore as well. And they are no longer around either. I don't know why. Lady and the Tramp with and the son, Little Fant. Which means that they are his son. And he managed to plummet into the water and they have to rescue him. And this dog learns his lesson, that's for sure. Yeah. So you see that... Yeah, if I do this, you can see the whole story, okay? So, there you have that. You gotta be careful with water, everyone. So, that's the lesson here with that story. Yeah, further on.
Mickey and Pluto is learning table manners. Pluto don't need to learn table manners when he's on the floor. What do you think? It says so here, Mickey and Pluto learn table manner. Okay. And you got some tasks that you can do, labyrinth and drawings and all of that.
Yes.
You need to have manner when you sit at the table, but don't expect a dog to have too much manner. Adventure, new adventure with Peter Pan, and here is another character I can't remember so much about, but that's the way it is. Yes. So, yeah, I don't know, but that's how it is. Here we go on. Cinderella, goodnight history again. Pictures of different trains. Is this Thomas the Train or something like that? If I didn't know better, I would say that, but that's the way it is. But I look a little bit different. I would say that. I have to angle this through the light, so if you see some shadows, it's because of my arms that are a little bit in the way. Jungle Book again. Okay, poor snake, I would say here. The bridge is down, and a fakir comes by, and he plays a melody for the snake to make a bridge so they can walk over. The snake would never be able to carry a tiger, two humans, and all of that, but that's the way it is. It's a story. So that's Jungle Book. Let's see, Alice in Wonderland again. Yeah, I'm just gonna show you a little bit, just very quickly, because I have so much magazines to show you here. So you just have to pause to read for yourself, okay, and look further on. So, I wish that some of these characters could return again. I think that would be nice. And this is a story about Pinocchio and his friends. Let's see. Yes. So, I'm just gonna swiftly do this and angle it so you can read this for yourself. So, that's the story about Pinocchio. And let's see, there is a story about Cinderella again. But here it comes to a character that are no longer around. Does anybody know about the Indian Hiawatha? Yes, I think it pronounced that. You might get a flashback here, okay? Because Cinderella is giving a good night story about Hiawatha, the Indian. This character I haven't seen in a while, I gotta say that. Pretty interesting to see this again. And this is also characters that are missing today. The backside of this I showed you earlier on. I'm gonna put that down and find you the next one, which is number 7 in this case. And the fox in Pinocchio, yes, I can't remember the fox, but in the picture, we have a picture of a fox here. Yes. Talking to Pinocchio about something, I don't know why. I don't know. And this is the back of it. Just to show you that, the Pinocchio's owner is sweeping the street, probably, and is watching them talking to Pinocchio there. Maybe they are some crooks or something, I don't know. First story is Pinocchio and his friends, yes. Just gonna do that, and just slide like that. That's the best I can do, so... That's how it is. Yes. So I'm just gonna go very Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Yes. So this is history. I gotta say that. Yeah, and it says also something that you can finally a magazine for children between 3 and 8 of age. Yeah. It's the magazine I'm holding here, actually. So they had some commercial for the magazines back in the day. Yes, they had. Lady and the Tramp and Son Fant again. Alright. Yeah, I think this is cool. This is old, and it's very cool to have in my collection. So since somebody had punched hole in it, I'm gonna do... Mickey and this tiny Indians, yeah. Mickey's sons are
dressed as Indians. I can't remember the name of those two characters, okay? I bet somebody knows and can leave a comment on that. Let's see if you can read the story here. If I go closer and I just slide like this, take it up again, slide like this, and like this. Just pause to read, okay? And here Pinocchio is riding a horse, a rocking horse, can I call it that, I think. And somebody has just drawn Pluto in there. And there are some mouse from Cinderella, is my guess. Peter Pan, New Adventures. And we also got some extra in here. What's that? Yeah, I'm gonna show you that later on. That was actually pretty cool. I'm gonna take that. First, New Adventures with Peter Pan, okay? Let's see, I'm bumping into the box that tripod stands on. Sorry for that. Yes. It's a short story because here it comes something called some drawings you can color. And they haven't taken it out, so that's cool, and not to draw this yet. So I'm gonna show you that. Look at that. And they are hanging from the bridge. And a fish at the bottom, okay? And here we got Pinocchio. Yeah, cool. Cool it is. Imagine that, all the way from 1973 and has not been touched or drawn on. So that's incredible, actually. I like it when people are taking good care of their books. Remember this? This is a commercial for us Aristocats. Aristocats, I think I pronounced that correctly. I hope I did. In sale in your local store, yeah, right. Not anymore, guys. And here comes the rest of the Peter Pan story. Yes, that's how it is. Yes. Next up is Cinderella Goodnight History. And here is Winnie the Pooh. Yes. So now Cinderella tells a story about Winnie the Pooh from the 100-yard forest or whatever it calls. 100-arch forest. I can't remember. I'm a Norwegian guy, okay? So I try my best here, okay? You know what I mean when you see the pictures. Yes. Let's see. Next page. Jungle Book. Shere Khan is on his way. I want to eat the human again, of course. Yes, that's how it is. Yeah. So, I hope you can see this. I just see through the viewfinder here. That something is showing. Alice in Wonderland. Yeah, that we here we have the Queen from Wonderland as well. Angry for something. Very angry, as you can see here. Yeah. So, this is, I called it classic characters. Yeah, and here is a drawing again. Somebody just drew a horse that Goofy is sitting on. Backwards, of course. And he's holding his tail. Poor horse. Scrooge McDuck. There is a story about him here as well. And it says Uncle Skrue McDuck here. It's Scrooge is Skrue up here, okay? I think I mentioned that in an earlier review as well. Read for yourself, okay? As best as you can. It's not easy. My arms are getting tired and I have a few magazines left to show you here. And here there are some tasks that you can do. And here is Donald Duck. You can color him up. Yeah, and that was that magazine. Next, I'm gonna put it down there. This is Dumbo at the front, actually. A nice picture of Dumbo. Yes, and this is the back of it. You can see have a safe flight, it says on the sign here. And you can see that Dumbo is taking off, actually, and flying into the air. Yeah. Okay, we are in June. 12th of June 1973, by the way. And this magazine cost 2.50 Norwegian, in Norwegian currency. Remember, this is 1973, and 8 Norwegian crowns is $1.
So 250, it was a lot of money back then. I can guarantee you that. You were very happy if you get some of these magazines back in the day. Dumbo, the Flying Elephant. I'm gonna start here. Yeah, I'm gonna just slide and do my best. So, yeah. Yes, my hand is in the way a little bit, but I hope it's okay. Next up, Alice in Wonderland again, with another story. Yes. So I'm just gonna briefly show you that, and you have to pause for yourself, okay? And there's some commercial about Peter Pan. For the magazine that I'm holding in my hands. Believe it or not, 2020, and I'm holding this magazine. Lady and the Tramp with the Sun Fant. Fant had his own show in the magazine back in the day as well. I know that. So it went on to be an own character for Disney back in the day. So there you have that. Yes. Let's go on. And here is New Adventures with Peter Pan. Together with Tinkerbell. And you got the pirate there. Yes. That's how it is. So the magazines are actually in good nick for despite the age of it. So I think this is a cool... It costs a little bit of money, but I don't care. When it comes to magazines like that, I will buy it right away. I don't care how much it costs. Because I love this. Mickey Mouse and the and Pluto. The ball that disappear. Okay. Let's see if I can bring you the story here. Yes. And there are some tasks that you can do here as well. Yes. Jungle Book, Mowgli was the name of the human. Okay, I couldn't remember that, but that's the way it is. Mowgli on New Adventures. Okay. I'm just sliding like that, okay? So pause and read for yourself, okay? Yes. Next page, let's see. Cinderella Goodnight History, this time is with Winnie the Pooh. And here the tiger looks a little bit different than you remember, I would say. Look at that. That's a weird tiger. But that's the tiger from back in the days. You can see that. It is different compared to the today. And the bee spotted that Winnie the Pooh has honey and chases him for that. Yeah, that's how it is. Bee loves honey, so does Winnie the Pooh. New Adventures with Peter Pan. Yes. Let's see, I have to tilt it like that so you get a better picture here. It is a little bit hard because the magazine is so big and you get some shadowing from the light as well. So that's the way it is. And here the pirate is chased by a crocodile. Yes. So there you have that. What do you think about this magazine, guys? I have a few more to show you, so that's the way it is. Alice in Wonderland again. Okay. Yes. So I think this is actually pretty cool and awesome to see. Yes. And the back I showed you earlier on. But here it says, hello boys and girls. And I can show you Mickey one more time here. So you can see Mickey here. Okay. Gonna put it down. And this front is Bambi this time. Yes. Yeah. I have to tilt it a little bit so you can see it better. And this is the back. Shows you some of the forest by a waterfall and some birds. And if I turn it around, you can see Bambi and all of that. Yes. Let's open and see what lurks inside here. Dumbo is starting up, of course.
Yes. I hope you can see this. I hope. I think you can. It's a little bit glossy, this magazine as well. So there you have it. That's why they are a little bit dark paper, and it's a little bit yellowed some places and all of that. It's old. But despite that, I think this is a good nick for what it is. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Look how beautiful that they made the drawings back in the day. Much better than what you see today, that's for sure. You don't see this today, actually, that detailed as this is. There's no chance you can see this as detailed today. Then you have to pay a fortune for the magazine if you want to have that. I guarantee that if this was in perfect nick, I wouldn't afford this magazine here. So Cinderella Good Night Histories about Hiawara again, the Indian. Let's see. Sorry if it is a little bit dark, but that's the best I can do. So I'm doing my best here, okay? So yeah, let's see. I have to hold it like this so you may be able to read this. Yes, that's how it is. Yes. I think this is a cool. And here is a story about Lady and the Tramp with Fanta again. Yeah. That's how it is. And I have to take away some scuff mark I saw here, but that one I managed to take away right away, so that's okay. Let's start here. Like that. Yes. It's not easy to hold this here, trust me when I say that. So I'm doing my best here, okay? Yes. Next up is Uncle Scrooge Dig After Gold. In the middle of the road, really? Okay. That's how it is. Looks like he's doing that, and you got a history again. Let's see. Can you see this? I hope you can. Because it's not so easy, this. So you have to pause for yourself and read this, okay? I'm not going to read this. We will be here forever. That's for sure. I'm not going to do that. And here you can puzzle with the drawings and all of that again. Yeah. Next up is Peter Pan again. With some adventure again. Let's see if I hold it here, you can see it a little bit better. Yes. Cinderella Good Night History. Today is the Three Pigs and the Wolf. We all remember that story, do we? I think we do. But here he's trying to blow down the pigs from a tree. Yes, let's see if you can get this hole in the frame here, so you can read for yourself. Here he tries to blow them down, but he gets apples all over him instead. Stupid wolf, with other words. Jungle Book, Mowgli on New Adventures. Okay, let's see if I can get that into the camera. Yes. I'm bumping into the box that the tripod and the camera are standing on. That's why you hear this sliding sound there. Sorry for that. Yeah, that's how it is. Let's see. Lady and the Tramp with Fanta again. Okay. Arguing with another dog over a bone. Okay. That's how it is. Yeah. That's how it is. Yes. Next page. Alice in Wonderland again. Yes. At least I can show you this in pieces. At least. So that's good. Let's see, there is another page here.
Pinocchio and his friends, okay? Very yellow paper, but I think the camera can pick it up anyway, so we will be good here. I hope. And I got a weak battery in the camera, so I need to make a jump cut and put in some electricity. Okay, hold on everyone. Next magazine comes up as soon as I plug this into the wall, okay? Stand by. Okay, I'm back. Jump cut has been made. And we're gonna start with the next magazine, okay? This is the Seven Dwarf from Cinderella, isn't it? I think it is. And this is the back of it. Yes, and it says, "Hello, boys and girls," at the top again. You can see it starts on the back side and continue on the front side. That's how it is. Yes, and I'm gonna start inside here as well. Let's see what we have. This is number 3, by the way. Yes. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, we're going to encounter some new characters here, that's for sure. And I see that this has a little bit... I need to fix some of the paper here on this one, because it has been a little bit badly done. But I think we can do this. Okay. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs starts it off. Let's see. Like that. Yes. Like that. Yes. Yeah. Lady and the Tramp with the Sanfant. I didn't remember actually before now when it shows it here that Fant was the son of Lady and the Tramp actually. I couldn't remember that. It's a long time ago. That's how it is. But it looks a little bit different compared to the later series with Fant. That's for sure. Okay, next page. We got... I can't remember the name of the cow, but... This is Goofy and Mickey. And Coffee on the Bed. Okay, that's the name of that story. Okay. Yes, and I'm just gonna do this again. And you have to read for yourself, okay? And here's some puzzles again. Yes, and Dumbo looking at a bottom of a hinge. Okay. That's how it is. Let's see. I have to find the next page here. That's Cinderella Goodnight History. And we got... Oh, this is characters I can't remember to say at least. But anyway. I'm gonna show you it anyway. Yes. And here is Jungle Book. Yes. Next up, Alice in Wonderland. Yes. It's a night theme on the picture here, yes, and some puzzles, some tasks to do, Pinocchio and his friends, okay? Let's see, can I bring the text a little bit better here? I hope you can read that. I hope. Yes, and the next page is Dumbo, the Flying Elephant. Here it starts by sleeping under a tree. He looks a little bit fat there, but maybe it is
because of the way he lays down. I don't know. That's just my guess. Yes. That's my guess. And the back I showed you already. And I need to take a couple of... Oh, no spray, sorry for that. Like that. And we're going to the next magazine. And this is a little bit... This is number... Does it say number 3 again? 1970... Oh, wow, this is 1972. That's because it is a little bit older, okay. Then we have something from 1972 as well. I didn't know about that because it says number 3. And I think we have been through number 3 already. That was probably 1973, okay. Then it's older than I thought. It says so. No, it says 73. Then I got a probably misread the number because it's so small. And I don't have glasses on me, so sorry for that. So this is from 1973 and this is number 3, the first edition, it says. Yes. My nose is a little bit tight again. I can't do anything about it because of the cold. Oops. Let's see. It's not easy to show this. Let's see if I hold it there. You can, maybe you can make it out. Lady and the Tramp here. I'm sitting at the cafe and waiting for the spaghetti and the meatballs. And this is the other side. You can see the chef singing here. And the other chef with the harmonica. I can't remember. So this is the back. This is the beginning of the picture. And if I turn it around, you get this. And I can also do this if it is possible. So you can see that, yeah. That's how it is. Yeah. This is the last magazine I have, but I'm gonna show you what I have here. And this is a little bit... I need to try to get into this. This has a little bit of a point here where I need to straighten out the paper. But the first stop is Dumbo and the Flying Elephant confronting a snake, and he wants to have his trunk look like the snake, okay? Let's see. I'm gonna start here. It isn't easy. I'm gonna do my best here, okay? Like that. Pause to read for yourself, okay? So you can see they try to paint his trunk the same color as the snake. Yeah. Probably to have that as a part of the show. Yes. And it looks like the snake didn't mind that. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. The paper smell really old with this magazine here. But that's expected actually. So yeah. So that's the way it is. Yes. Next page, everyone. Let's see what we have. And this is a story about Mickey Mouse and the Weird Out shoes. Well, then you need a new pair of shoes, Mickey. But that's the history of the shoes that are Weird Out. Okay? It says so here. So if you can read Norwegian, just pause and read for yourself. Okay? I'm just gonna do like that because it's easier and it saves a lot of time and you will not be bored to death. And here is a big bird. Somebody already drawn the puzzle of the bird. I can't remember. Is it a stork? I think it is. A stork. Yes, and there's more puzzles here and so on. There are some text there as well if you can manage to get something out of that. Yes. Next page, Peter Pan, Adventure with Peter Pan, and here is watching some soldiers walking down the street, okay. Yeah. Yes. Cinderella Goodnight History with a cow called Ferdinand.
And this bull, sorry, not cow, but bull, Ferdinand. This story is a classic that has been sent as an animated movie every single year up here where I live. Every Christmas, this has been on the TV. So this story should be familiar with a lot of people. That's my guess. And this is, of course, a short version of it. Of course. And the Ferdinand end his days under the tree again to smell the flowers. That's his hobby. He wants to smell the flower and not fight at all. That's how it is. Jungle Book, Mowgli on New Adventures. Yes. Bear is in the water. Try to run on a log. Or stumble on a log or whatever it is. And he spotted that somebody are laughing of him. Yeah. I'm gonna slide it one more time so you can see this a little bit better. And I had to tilt it so you see this. And now he learns to ride the log. Okay. Maybe people will look at him and, yeah, think that's cool. But again, he falls and they laugh. But the bear doesn't care. That's how it is. Find it funny. It's good. Alice in Wonderland. Oh, the page is a little bit stuck here. Hold on, I have to make it open without too much damage. Yes, I'm gonna show you this. Here it play with the soldier cards. Okay. Yes. I don't know how well you can read the text here, but because the cells is in different colors where the text are, but all right, that's how it is. Puzzle task at the bottom. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs are outside and playing music. Okay, let's see. Yeah, and some puzzles at the bottom again. Yes, let's see, next page. It's Pinocchio and his friends again. This time, he's out to play a sort of a ball game, okay? Yes. And we got new history with Peter Pan, and this last page here is very, very loose. So I got to be careful here, and I have to bend this back. So hold on. I need to tape that site. I see that. It's a little bit weird, but I hope it's possible to see this anyway. So I need to be very careful here, so I don't loosen to cut up the sides totally from the magazine here. If that makes any sense for you. You can see down the bottom here, it's a little bit not at the good side. I see that. But let's see. Yeah, you can see the text. If I do like that, you see the text anyway. So that's okay. This magazine needs to be fixed up a little bit, that's for sure. And this was the last one I have to show you today. Disneyland magazine, okay? So this is the bunch of magazines that I have. Let's see if I can spread it out a little bit to show you what I just showed you today. Oh, it's a lot of magazines here. Like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 magazines. Yeah, it's a little bit hard to hold this, but if I do like that, you see that. So now I need to find something to put this in, since it has these holes here already, if I do like that. Since it's already there, I should put them in a protection case. That would be fine. So, yeah. First one, or the last one I showed you. And that's the with the dwarfs. And that was with Bambi. Yeah. Dumbo. Yes. And Pinocchio, and some foxes or whatever it is.
Mickey riding a train. Yes. And the free sample. So there you have it. What do you think about these magazines, guys? 1973. The first one was number one. And the other one was number four. And this the other one was seven. And this was number 10. Okay. Number 11 and 3. Then you know what kind of numbers this magazine was. So now it is for me just to thank you for watching my review. And I will be back with more gaming review later on as well. And other cool stuff. Just wait and see, everyone. I saw that I have already now 150 subscribers to my channel. Thank you. Okay. And I wish you all a pleasant day. And I will be back with more very soon. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.